Oops. Now it's my audio. Is that better?
Oh, there we go.
Okay. All right. Now, actually, hello, everybody. This is my first live stream. I've been running the camera for Alexandra for a while now. But this is the first time in front of the camera. So Alexandra does a lot of the traditional illustration and 2D work, and she's going to be doing all of that on the channel and also speaking to creativity and how to foster your own creative spirit. And I am going to be doing a lot of the how-to kind of camera YouTube-y stuff, and also all of the sewing and woodworking and kind of physical making stuff part of the channel. So today we're making a lens filter holder. I made this maybe 3 months ago. This is a solid version one. I've been using it ever since, and it's worked awesome. So it holds all of these little photo lenses that go, and then all of the adapters that fit the filters to your lenses. So I wanted something that was really easy to get access to, and also didn't take up much room, but provided enough protection where I felt okay tossing it in my bag. And this has worked really, really, really well. So I drafted up a new version on the computer, and like 2D pattern in Illustrator, Adobe Illustrator. And I took that pattern and took it upstairs to the Cricut that my mom got Alexandra for Christmas and cut out all the fabric. So this is kind of like a cooking show. I already have one finished, and we're gonna look at the parts and assemble version two today. So let's take the trusty sewing machine, put that down for a second, and switch to camera two. All right, so we have our thread. I've got all my bobbins. And then this is everything that I cut out, all the patterning that I've did for the entire filter. I also did an iron on. Oh, there we go. Sewing is a little bit difficult to film because you almost want three cameras. You almost want a camera here, a camera down here, and then you also want a camera shooting straight down. So I'm gonna do my best with two, but I also, let's cut back the materials. I have even more. I have all of these little rubber pieces. These are gonna provide a little bit more friction. This works pretty well because it was sewn kind of shoddily, so it gets hung up on itself, so it doesn't slide out. It actually kind of locks itself until you really pull it, which is actually kind of nice, but, you know, just having your sewing be poor, making the product work bothers me. So I'm adding a couple rubber pieces inside to give it a little bit more friction, and I'm also adding these pieces inside the filter holders to give a little bit more grip. And then I have some of the trim that I already pre-folded with a bone folder. And I think that's it. Oh, and the tongue for this design is gonna be orange, because I kind of like this fun safety orange. All right, well, let's get the sewing machine and we'll start going. Thank you. Louise wants an ollie cam. Oh, Alexandra with the fabric type. Good call. Let's bring this back in. There we go. Okay. This fabric right here is called X-Pack. It's actually what it was derived from sailboat sails. So really high performance sailboats use this material for their sails. It's extremely strong and very, very abrasion resistant. And then this is wax canvas, and wax canvas has this amazing quality where, I don't want to crunch it up too much, but if you crunch it and crease it, it leaves behind all of these witness marks. So it wears really, really nicely, and it almost kind of wears like leather. So it's a really, really great fabric. And that's it, and I like how they kind of contrast each other. All right, let's get picture in picture. There we are. I'm on a wheelie chair, so I'm gonna try not to roll around too much as we go. How's my audio? Do I need to go up a hair? I can probably go up a little bit. Okay, good. This is by no means a tutorial because I taught myself how to sew when the pandemic started. So the Christmas before the pandemic, Louise, who's on the stream, very kindly gave me this awesome book by this Nordic dude all about sewing bags. And it totally got me hooked on sewing. So when the pandemic hit and I needed something to do, some form of like construction or making, I didn't have enough room for a wood shop, so I turned to sewing, and then I really enjoyed it ever since. All right, so thanks, Louise. Really appreciate it. You fostered all of this. All right, let's get started. I'm gonna turn the music back up. First thing I'm gonna do is turn down my audio. And then this square right here is the front patch. And on my original design, each side is the same. And I thought that was kind of boring. So on this one, I added, yeah. Music's too loud now. How's this? Give it 4 seconds though. Is this better? Okay. Thanks, stream keeper. Can I just give you the magic key?
Yeah, that's fine.
Here. Now a moderator, honey. Oh, you can change it on your Stream Deck. If you open the Stream Deck controller.
Oh, can I do it from here?
Yeah. You can actually.
Ryan wants to hear you breathing.
Ryan's used to hearing me breathe because we play video games together. And when you get a fancy headset, you just have to force your friends to hear you breathe and drink water. And but I know Ryan likes it. All right, if you're new to sewing, the first thing you gotta do is load your bobbin. Do you? I brought everything down except for my scissors. Thank you. Oh, these are great. Have you been hiding these?
No, I got them like a few weeks ago at the antique shop. Oh.
Are they sharp? Yes.
But also,
Gavin, Louise, the water. He drinks so much water. That's true. Oh, shoot. You know what? I'm loading this. I don't want to. These machines have an auto threader, but I broke it the other day. Okay. First stitch. There we go. How cool is that? Whoa. There we go. So, the fun part about sewing, I made my first mistake already. So this is a great stitch. Oh. Except there's a big stagger on this edge. If you can see it here, there's a little bit of a jump. So now we need to fill out everybody's favorite tool, the seam ripper. And we're gonna undo what we just did. So you inevitably make a ton of mistakes sewing, especially because I've still only been doing this for like a year and a half. But that's why they have seam rippers. And you just get to do it all over again. Pull out these weird little pieces. Now I have to figure out why I did that. Oh, and that time, it's perfect. Huzzah. So now, can just cut this. And this. Take this little piece here and flatten it back. And then we sew down that line again. I can imagine Amelia just going, wow. Cool. So that's the first panel. You know what? Let's cut cameras. How about that? First panel. Let's see. It should be the same size. And it is. So that's the front. That's the back. And now we just have to stitch them together. So I'm actually gonna wait to join these two pieces until we work on the interior, because the interiors are a lot more complicated and we can finish this off later. All right. I'm gonna take the sewing machine down again. Camera. I need some scotch tape, so I will be right back. Okay, we are back. Tasteful font choice. Yeah, this is Alexandra and I's favorite. Is that even how you say that? Alexandra and I's? Alexandra and thy? It is Alexandra and my own favorite font. Greycliff. Oh, and my computer died. I'm gonna just said my password out loud. Okay, we're back. Yeah, Alexander and I both love Great Cliff. So we'll use it on almost everything. Okay, so all of these pieces here go on the inside. So it's pretty easy to lose track of what you're doing and why you're doing it. So it's best to kind of tape some things together just to start. Perfect example. These are all curly, but these pieces here are actually the interior of our outside patches. And they get stitched together to the inside of the patch later on. So I'm actually gonna put those to the side because they're a very similar shape but slightly different size to the other interior pieces. So I'm gonna pull those out. And now we're left with just the inside of the pouch, which is this piece here. So we're gonna assemble this entire piece on its own, and then we're gonna assemble the sheath on its own, and then they're actually connected inside with this cable here, so that you can't really pull it out all the way, and the way you push that back in is just by kind of jamming it back in. What's Connery Fagan? All right. Oh, and then also, I didn't touch on this piece. This piece of cutting board plastic goes inside, and that's how this whole thing gets its rigidity. Oh, the type house. No, Great Cliff is from Creative Market. It was like $50. Best $50 ever. Okay. Kept the X-Pack on a roll, so it's been rolling up on itself, which is pretty annoying. Great Cliff is like our font, so it was totally worth it. Bless you, honey. All right. Sorry, I'm doing some mental planning here. I guess all planning is mental. It's kind of redundant to say that. All right. Yes. Okay. Ryan, what fabric is M talking about? All right, my next step is going to be to put this edge banding on the top of these pieces here. And turned off another mic to cough, which didn't work. Oh, the rigid fabric. She likes this stuff. No, the other one. Does she like the X-Pack, which is the one that has all the little X's in it, or the canvas, the yellow canvas? Oh yeah, Ryan, yeah. She likes the X-Pack. Yeah, I love this color. Not the fabric purple? Oh, I'm so confused. The one that goes inside. That's the purple fabric. Okay, so what I'm doing right now is putting these little clippies on. To make sure I sew this bad Larry straight. To load a different thread to do that. I think I shot around this process last time. It's kind of like a wine colored red. I guess it's kind of purple. I don't know, I like it though. Scissors. Thank you. I can't hold still. I'm trying to read your Apple Watch. Oh, Alexandra is complimenting me. Oh, so, ta-da. That's one piece done. Alexandra's very biased. Oh my god, Alexandra bias.
I haven't heard that one yet.
Really?
Yeah. Mm-hmm.
Takes a real creative. Oh, we're up to 4 viewers now. We're really cooking with gas. Oh, YouTube money, here we come. One day, I'm gonna buy a candy bar with YouTube. These little clips. They're really great. I hate pinning. So these are really nice. The last one. Can you read that, Louise? Oh, that'll feel good. No. Excuse me, well, I clear my throat. Okay. Alexandra, you're going to lose your moderator status here.
Oh, because I'm the one being in a program.
That's like my joke the other day. All right, now I'm just trimming off all these little dudes. These are really good scissors. Next, we're gonna find our inside pieces here. There. Now we have to bond the lower filter holder together. Oh, actually, this is a new step for these ones. We have to stitch the rubber liner to them. And this is all gonna be done in red thread. So, oh, dropping stuff. We get to do the handy dandy bobbin change. Oh God. I'm sure people that have been doing this for a really long time are way better at managing when to use what color so they don't have to keep switching. But I'm new. Rubber liner. So the hard thing about sewing the rubber liner is this piece right here is really sticky, so it can't actually go under the foot, or it will just get stuck under the foot and then bunch up. So you have to be really careful with how you sew it and what side of the foot it's on, which can be kind of tricky. and rubber piece. So when this guy goes in, so we'll get covered up just like that. Now I'm just trying to figure out where this next one will go. I can reference the one I already made to kind of see that gap. Okay. I have a chalk pencil, and I'll use the chalk pencil with a ruler here. This is 3 inches tall. And I know that the top of the piece ends right at this corner, so I'm just gonna measure down. On both sides. Sorry if you can't see this very well. That's where the rubber will go on this side. Holy smokes, folks, it's already been an hour. All right, there you go. They are not even because the lower panel sits deeper inside of the piece here. All right, we have the other piece. And now that we already kind of laid it out, we know what we want to do, we're just gonna do it over. just have a massive pile of thread going. Ugh. Had a spider living in our office for like 3 days now. So every time I feel like a little like tickle on my neck or something, I think it's the spider. So true, Louise. I just gotta give in and let the spider bite me. Interior of both pieces are now done. Now we can attach the bottoms. I'm gonna use my handy clips. Bless you.
I held it in place. The third one didn't make it.
You're a monster, Harry. Sometimes the sewing machine doesn't like starting in the thickest fabric. Oh, it's gonna do it again. third time is the charm. Ugh. It's a regular needle. I've been using it the whole time. Oh, you know what it is? The needle jump the tensioner. Oh, whoops. There's a cut. There's a tension arm right here, and sometimes the thread jumps out of that arm. And when the tension isn't perfect in a sewing machine, it just starts tying knots in the bottom. Fourth time's the charm. Sounds better. Oh. We're back. Perfect. All right, so that's our first pocket. So your filters and accessories will just slide right in there. Just like that. And then this will still reduce by half an inch because we're gonna lose a quarter inch on each side when we stitch it to the other side, the other piece. All right. Measurement 3 inches. Keep dropping that. Okay, I'm going to go up a quarter of an inch on each side and make a line. one of the reasons I really like having this chalk pencil is you can make much thinner lines than you could with the wax or Taylor's chalk or Taylor's soap. Okay, because you see this pocket, you can't just stitch it flat like that. It wouldn't work. You'd see this edge and it would look really crappy. So what you actually have to do is stitch your first stitch upside down. And I'll show you why in a second. So now when you fold this back, you have a really clean edge. Alright, so we're now at a point where we have an actual thing. So let's just double check. Everything fits nicely. Do that on the other side. So one thing is that these pockets are actually oversized by about an eighth of an inch on each side. And when you oversize a pocket, or when you oversize the front patch, that's how you get this little bit of a pucker there. And that's what allows you to put something in there and not have it be just extremely tight. Kind of what forms the pocket. And these seams don't have to be super strong because you're basically assembling this piece and this structure at a quarter or an eighth of an inch seam allowance. And then when you stitch these two together, and they're matched up, you stitch those at a quarter inch. So you'll never even see these seams. All right, I'm gonna do the same thing here. Make sure this is 3 inches. It is. So this is the first sewing project I've assembled where everything was cut on the Cricut. I'm loving it because everything is super accurate. All my measurements are exactly the same. All my angles are perfect. It's actually really hard to transpose some patterns by just using the measurements and freehanding them. Dropsies today. The total dropsies. All right. So these are completely assembled. How much headroom did I have at the top of this? Oh, none. Okay. So the next step is take these two matching pieces and sew them together so that they're one piece. But there's a couple things to consider when sewing. You have to hide your seams, so you're actually going to sew them face to face. And after you sew them face to face, you leave a gap at the bottom and you push them through each other so that they become this shape again. It's kind of confusing. You have to think of everything kind of inside out and reversed. And we also have to remember to leave a hole at the bottom big enough for our plastic piece to fit in. And we have to remember to stitch in our top handle. Whoop. Whoop. There we go. So I'm actually going to do that first, just so I don't forget it. And you know what? Because this is looking pretty good so far, I'm even going to measure where this should go. This is another weird thing. So this is going to be the pull tab, which is this pull tab right here. But to make it come out like that, you need to attach it upside down so that when you invert it, it pops out of the top. Kind of doesn't make sense unless you sew a lot to think about all the weird little nuances. It also could be weird that I'm wrong. And that would be crazy. Or not really. jam up. Still looks good. Try again. Now for the moment of truth to see if we actually made all the correct decisions. I think this is like the most nerve-wracking point of any sewing project. One thing was right. Definitely made my tab correctly. A little bit off the plastic. A little bit more. Oh, this hole is the thing, is the purple that Amelia likes. Oh, well, that's good, because it also turned out that it worked. So now, moment of truth. Put our filter in. And the rubber worked pretty good. That's pretty exciting. I'm sure when we get something on the other side too, it will really stick. But I would say that that is a pretty wild success. Oh yeah, I guess I didn't really show that very well. I was too excited. load in the bottom. Load in the top. There you go. So that's the insert. Throwing a couple extra stitches in the bottom to seal up that little piece, strengthen that seam because I didn't do a back stitch because I kind of thought I was going to seam rip the whole thing on accident. Gotta put in this little stretchy tail. Doesn't have to be as exact. Oh, good job. Still rolling everywhere in my chair. Okay. This stitching doesn't have to be as pretty because no one's ever going to see it. Do that. this is where we're at. Unfortunately, I think the plastic piece inside is a little bit too large. Kind of see it has a little bit of a concave shape to it, so it's creating a bigger space on one side than the other. And I think we're gonna have to pull it out and cut it down, which sucks because I just did two entire stitches on that side. But this is the final one, so I want it to be the right thing. If it takes a minute to seam rip it and another minute to cut it down, then it's totally worth it. So I'm gonna be using this for a bunch of years to come. I'll be frustrated about that. Pull out all these fuzzies now. really check. Make sure this is good. Yes. All right. Let's do that again. All right, let's try a fit test one more time. Much better. That's great. And they stay in. Perfect. So what's crazy, and kind of the reason I'm building this, is this little filter is really super important for video work because it allows you to shoot at really shallow apertures outside by blocking a lot of the light, and it blocks it just by changing the relationship between these two polarized pieces of glass. But this little thing is $275. So it needs to be protected, but you also don't want to make it so protected that you can't use it anymore. So that's what this was for. And even something like this, this is a Cinebloom filter. It makes everything, I can actually show you, makes everything kind of cloudy. Adds a nice little haze when you're shooting outside in sunlight. It makes everything look a little bit ethereal, but even this, it was like $75 or something, so it gets kind of expensive. Which is the reason you have all these step rings, so you can fit them to all your different lenses without buying a different filter for every lens. So it's nice having it all together, and it's nice having it really easily accessible and available to you. All right, that section's done. Now we get to stitch the outside and stitch the inside. While we have the red going, let's stitch the inside. Dandy red clips. It's weird, I don't watch too many sewing tutorials, but I was actually watching Adam Savage make a spacesuit, which is like a very Adam Savage thing to do. And he hired a seamstress for all the complicated stuff. And she was using these awesome tiny little clips for everything. And I was like, oh my God, I have to get some. And so far, they're great. They're so much easier than pinning, especially because I always catch pins under my fingernails, and that's like excruciatingly painful and awful. These are great. But Ryan, if you're still on, if Amelia ever needs anything made out of this purple fabric and canvas, I could make her a wallet or a little purse, birthday gifts, whatever she wants. I think I still have a yard of it, and I have 2 yards of the canvas. All right, so that's the inside. That is, oh yeah, that's where this will live. Perfect. Oh, you know what? I was supposed to sew a piece of rubber to that. Sell this outside show. And I'm gonna sew this with red. Because I think even if it peeks through, it will look okay. So the only thing with wax canvas is you don't want to make too many mistakes, because it leaves marks when you do thread ripping and when you have to rip stitches and you don't stitch it in the exact same spot. What are we for time? Probably go a little bit over. Cool. About that. These are those witness marks I was talking about with wax canvas. It looks so awesome. All right. Check the fitment here. It's perfect. It's probably a little tall. Hey, Alexandra. Need your opinion on something. Do I go around the edge of this with red thread or gold? Red hides it here, but then has like a nice accent all around. Gold would just look like this.
I think because you have the type there, I would do yellow.
Just to stick with the gold.
Yeah, because if you did red, I think it would be too much going on.
Okay, I agree. I agree.
But it looks awesome.
Yeah, it's coming out really nice.
Yeah.
If I don't say so.
If it didn't say so, is it?
Yep. So one thing I'm doing now is when I created my pattern, I forgot to account for the fact that this inside fabric doesn't get folded inside itself, so I didn't need so much of a seam allowance. So to make up for it, I just sewed another 1/4 inch all the way around, and I'm going to cut that off. I know that kind of probably doesn't sound like English. But I made it too big. That's the English. Now it should fit inside. This should fit inside. I'll make it just a little bit smaller. So now we're really like narrowing down how small this can really be, so I don't want to cut anything yet. Yeah, and it's a good thing because that's too small. So I'm going to grab the seam ripper. And just rip one side. The nice thing is that this X-Pack is really easy to seam rip because the seam ripper just glides right on top. Let's try that again. It's nice and snug. That's really nice. Perfect. I'm just going to stiffen up these corners. They'll take a lot of abuse. That one's pretty tough, but cool, all done with the red thread, all done with the inside. Everything fits really well. All right, let's pull this out. Put in the gold. Let's see, okay, well, you know what, we lost our tunes. What we're doing here is just going to trace the edge with the gold thread, and this is going to just define the shape. Thank you. little wonky on the bottom, but that's all right. Today. So we have our outside shell, we have our inside shell, which is the Kydex, so kind of gives a little bit more of a finished look, and it's something for the lens to slide in. And then we have this piece, so let's see, this piece lives inside the Kydex. Or X-Pack, sorry, lives inside this bigger piece. And they all make a very nice fitting sandwich. Just like this. So the last step is to attach some edge banding around the top, and then reach in, pull out the middle of this, and stitch it to the bottom of this. Cool. So what I'm doing now is just fitting the edge binding around the top. I do wish this came in a different color, but this is the first time doing this step with these clips, so I hope it is a little helpful, because this step sucks and I always mess it up somehow at least once. The other thing would be to not edge bind them. Thank you. I think that's what I'm gonna do. So instead of doing this detail, I'm gonna do a detail more like, I have an example, more like this. But it means I have to seam rip this edge that I just did, stitch them together, invert them, and then stitch this bottom. But I think that's what I'm gonna do. Kind of okay because this stitch was wavy and it was bothering me. So let's see, can you even see this? You can't even see me doing this. you actually make it blue instead? So now I'm just trying to pull it apart. See, wherever it doesn't come across, come out easy. This is where I got lazy with the seam ripper. That's a good one. A lot of thread rippers have brushes on the back of them. so you can brush out all these little pieces. I'll have to get a shot of this like ridiculous pile of pulled out threads and cutoffs. Now I gotta open up a hole. Bless you. Bless you. Very carefully seam up the bottom of this. Put an extra stitch. Drop my pedal. Put an extra stitch right here just to reinforce. On the other side to reinforce. Thank you. all this extra stitching I did kind of did me dirty. Always the most dangerous part of a project is like you're getting to the end, it's getting late. Kind of want it to be done, but you worked really hard on all the planning. So, you don't want to screw that up. Inside this. All of this. So my plan right now, I guess I should probably speak that out loud, is to take this top edge, stitch it all the way around, reach inside with the hole I made, grab this, and then pull it completely inside of itself. Flip this inside out. I don't even know if I needed that hole. Kind of questioning all my decisions now. I've sewn myself into a corner. All right, the main problem is you can't really go around the top of this and stitch these, focus, together. Because this is so much larger, these circles aren't the same size, so you'll end up with a wrinkle. So I'm thinking the thing to do is to just find the middle of each and stitch them, and then pull it inside. Yeah. Weird. think this is a layer of problem solving in sewing that is what makes it so interesting to me. Also so frustrating. I feel like most of the corners I work myself into in sewing, I'm really not qualified to work my way out of, if that makes any sense. Just going on instinct. So now what I'm gonna do is fold this back the other way. Do the same stitch. Try and make sure that it's even on both sides. Even though there's really no way to tell. Truth. You know what? No idea how I did that. This is like the fun of sewing, though. I feel like I really worked myself into a corner. But I feel like this stream has also been going on for 3 hours. But I have to finish. This is fascinating. I am completely vexed. And I'm gonna have to sort this out on another stream. So, thank you for watching. I really appreciate it. And I hope you have a wonderful night and Happy New Year. See ya.